Have you ever heard the question, if you were stranded on a deserted island, what three items would you bring? What would you need to survive there? What if we're talking about the desert? Would that change your answer? The desert isn't quite as deserted as you might think. While it is a harsh place to live and may look abandoned, there are actually many living things who have found a way to survive here. Sometimes it's the way their bodies are shaped. Sometimes it's more about the way the animals behave. We call these special strategies adaptations. Today, we're going to take a closer look at some animals who have adapted to call the desert biome home. We're glad you're watching Socratica Kids. You know us for our smart, fun videos, but did you know there's more to the Socratica Foundation website? You'll find courses, worksheets, games, and even educational souvenirs for your home or classroom. Visit socratica.org to hashtag learn more. Up first, we have the utterly adorable Fennec Fox, which is a small, nocturnal predator native to the deserts of North Africa and the Sahara. Its most distinctive feature is its oversized ears, which can grow up to 6 inches or 15 centimeters long. These large ears help the Fennec Fox dissipate heat and, more obviously, help with hearing and allow them to hear prey moving underground. Fennec Foxes have light-colored fur that reflects sunlight during the day and provides camouflage in the sandy environment. So even though the desert might look deserted, these furry friends could be hiding in plain sight. They are omnivores and eat insects, small mammals, birds, and fruits. Because water is so scarce in the desert, Fennec Foxes obtain most of their moisture from the food they eat, which reduces their need to drink water directly. They live in burrows to stay cool during the hottest times of day and emerge at night to hunt. While Fennec Foxes usually fly under the radar, there's another desert animal that's nearly impossible to miss. The Dromedary Camel, also known as the Arabian Camel, is the ultimate desert survivor. Found in the deserts of the Middle East and North Africa, these camels are well adapted to withstand the harsh conditions of the desert biome. Dromedary camels have a single hump, which stores fat they can metabolize for energy when food is scarce. Contrary to popular belief, camels do not store water in their humps, but they are very good at conserving water. They can go for several days without drinking and can lose up to 30% of their body weight in water without suffering dehydration. When they do drink, they can consume up to 30 gallons or 113 liters of water in one session. Their thick coats protect them from the sun, and their wide padded feet prevent them from sinking in the sand. Walking through sand can be tough, so having padded feet is very useful. Another animal who is good at navigating the sand is the Sidewinder Snake. The Sidewinder Snake is known for its unique sideways slithering motion that helps it move across the hot sand. This small, venomous snake is found in the deserts of the southwestern United States and northern Mexico. The Sidewinder Snake's sideways movement minimizes contact with the scorching sand, allowing it to conserve energy and avoid overheating. These snakes are ambush predators. It's exactly what it sounds like. They bury themselves in the sand with just their eyes and nose exposed and wait for small animals like rodents and lizards to pass by. Then they ambush their prey, and that's dinner. Another helpful tool is Sidewinders have heat-sensitive pits near their eyes, which help them detect warm-blooded prey even in complete darkness. Next time you're in the desert, watch out for these snakes because they're highly venomous. Another venomous creature of the desert is the Gila Monster. The Gila Monster is one of the few venomous lizards in the world and is native to the deserts of the southwestern United States and Mexico, just like the Sidewinder Snake. These reptiles are easy to remember. Just look for their bright, bead-like scales and patterns of black, pink, and orange. Gila Monsters are slow-moving, but their venom is potent enough to subdue small mammals, birds, and other prey. Unlike snakes, they don't inject venom through fangs. Instead, it flows into their victim as they chew. Yikes! Gila monsters spend most of their time underground, emerging only to hunt or bask in the sun. They have a slow metabolism, which allows them to go for long periods without eating. And they store fat in their tails for energy during times when food is scarce. Even though they have a fearsome reputation, Gila monsters are generally not aggressive and will only bite if threatened. Switching over to an animal who spends their time running above ground, we have the Roadrunner. The Roadrunner is a bird famous for its speed and agility, often seen darting through the deserts of the southwestern United States. These birds can run at speeds of up to 20 miles or 32 kilometers per hour, making them one of the fastest running birds on Earth. I bet the name makes a little more sense now. Roadrunners are not picky eaters and will eat many animals, including insects, lizards, small mammals, and even venomous snakes like rattlesnakes. They have strong legs and sharp beaks that they use to catch and kill their prey. Unlike many other birds, roadrunners spend most of their time on the ground, using their speed to chase down prey and escape predators. They are also capable of short flights, but they rely mainly on their running abilities to navigate the desert. Not all desert animals are fast. In fact, some are incredibly slow. The desert tortoise is a slow-moving reptile that has adapted to life in arid deserts. These tortoises spend up to 95% of their lives in burrows, where they stay cool during the hot summer months and avoid freezing temperatures in the winter. Desert tortoises are herbivores and mostly eat grasses, wildflowers, and cacti. These tortoises have the unique ability to store water in their bladders, which helps them survive long periods when they can't find water. When it does rain, desert tortoises will drink large amounts of water and store it for future use. Their hard, domed shells protect them from predators, and their strong limbs allow them to dig burrows and navigate the rocky terrain. What do you think so far? Could you see yourself living in the desert biome with the tortoise and the roadrunner and the sand and the no water? We do have a video all about this biome as part of our Biome series. So when we say biome, we don't just mean the environment or the animals, but everything. Who lives there? What is the climate like? The whole shebang. We'll link the series below. You might be familiar with kangaroos, but what about the kangaroo rat? The kangaroo rat is a small nocturnal rodent that is named for its long hind legs, which allow them to jump great distances, up to 9 feet or 2.7 meters in a single leap. Kangaroo rats are well adapted to desert life and can survive without drinking any water at all. They get all the moisture they need from the seeds they eat, and their kidneys are masters at conserving water. Kangaroo rats have fur-lined cheek pouches that they use to carry food back to their burrows, where they store it for later use. Starting to notice some similarities between kangaroos and kangaroo rats? Leaping, pouches, so much in common. They are active mainly at night to avoid the extreme heat of the day, and their burrows provide shelter from predators, like the Sidewinder snake and the harsh desert climate. Potentially one of the most well-known desert critters, scorpions are known for their venomous sting and fearsome appearance. There are over 2,000 species of scorpions worldwide, and many of them live in desert environments. Scorpions are nocturnal hunters and use their pinchers to catch prey such as insects, spiders, and small rodents. They have a venomous stinger at the end of their tail, which they use to defend themselves and subdue their prey. Scorpions can survive in some of the harshest conditions on Earth. For example, these bugs can slow down their metabolism, which makes it possible to survive on very little food. Some species can go up to a year without eating. Scorpions are also able to sense vibrations in the ground, which helps them detect approaching prey or predators. One such predator that scorpions need to watch out for is the coyote. Coyotes are a highly adaptable predator found in deserts, grasslands, and forests across North America. So while you can find them in the desert, they live in other biomes too. Coyotes are omnivores, and they eat more than just scorpions. Other creatures that need to watch out are small mammals, birds, insects, and reptiles, but they also eat fruit. In the desert, they're often scavengers and will feast on remains left behind by other predators. Coyotes are great hunters, often working in pairs or small groups to catch larger prey like deer. They are also known for their distinctive howls, which they use to communicate with other members of their pack and establish their territory. Another animal who calls multiple biomes home is the meerkat. The meerkat is a small social mammal native to the deserts of southern Africa. These animals live in large groups called mobs or clans, which can get up to 50 individuals. Meerkats are known for their cooperative behavior, with members of the group taking turns to watch for predators while the others forage for food. Meerkats live in burrows to stay cool during the day and avoid predators. They have excellent digging skills and use their sharp claws to excavate intricate tunnel systems in the desert soil. By spending a lot of time underground, meerkats stay safe from other dangerous animals who might be roaming the desert surface. Now, it's well known that humans have beards, but what about lizards? The bearded dragon is a lizard native to the deserts of Australia, known for the spiny beard of scales under its chin that puffs up when the animal feels threatened. So it's not exactly a beard like humans have, but you get the idea. Bearded dragons are cold-blooded and rely on the sun to regulate their body temperature. In the cooler parts of the day, they bask in the sun to warm up, and when it gets too hot, they retreat to the shade or burrow into the sand. Bearded dragons are also able to change the color of their skin to help regulate their temperature. Dark colors absorb more heat, so when bearded dragons are cold, they can darken to stay warm. The bearded dragon is also a popular pet in many parts of the world. They are calm and hardy, making them a great pet. So, have you changed your mind about living in the desert? Not so deserted, is it? While the desert may sometimes look empty, it's actually full of life. The animals of the desert have some amazing survival strategies. These creatures have mastered the art of conserving water, avoiding the scorching heat, and finding food in the most unlikely places. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.